thrilling concert by over 500 performers at a world-renowned venue, A Night at the Meyerson. The finale of Southwestern's annual music festival brings you a captivating mix of classical and modern music featuring the Wind Symphony, orchestra, and choir. A night of inspiration, A Night at the Meyerson.
Thank you. concert has been part of the Southwestern tradition for 21 years. Our program tonight is remarkably eclectic, ranging from Mozart and spirituals to folk music. There's an amazing percussion performance called Island Jam No. 7. Watch for that. A modern march, and the thousands of dollars aside. By the way, five of the pieces performed tonight are written by living composers. Before we begin, one reminder, please turn off your cell phones. Out of respect for tonight's musicians, we request complete silence on the record. One more thing. It's a custom that concert audiences do not applaud between the movements in the suite of the chair that are going to be on. I invite the audience to stand as we speak. Eternal Father, Maker of heaven and earth, founded every blessing. We pause at the beginning of this concert to ask for your blessings. We pray that all of your children, every note, will be a sweet incense of praise to you. In the name of our Savior.
would like to say just a quick word about the first piece that we performed, the Danse Macabre by Saint-Saëns. It's part of a type of symphonic music that is called a symphonic poem. As you can tell, the music is very picturesque, and you can imagine, well, I guess a Danse Macabre is all about bones and I guess dead things, really. So I guess the concert doesn't start really on a very, very bright side. But don't worry, it's going to get better. We're actually getting to a piece that is extremely soothing, a piece that is originally for piano, one of the two arabesques that Debussy wrote. And we're going to do the Clair de Lune, as orchestrated by André Caplet.
Thank you.
The last piece that we're going to perform for you, probably you know it already, if any of you have watched Disney's Fantasia 2000. It's the last two movements from the Firebird Suite by Stravinsky. And we hope you enjoy it as much as we do enjoy it. All right, thank you.
There are several sponsors for tonight's concert. And at this point, we'd like to recognize these organizations and individuals. As I call out your names, please stand to receive the applause of the audience. Texas Health Hughley. Are the representatives from Texas Health here? Thank you in any case. Pinnacle Bank, Texas. Southwestern Union Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. Cockrell Innovation. Karen and Booger Putnam. Dan Zacharias. Reed Billingsley Real Estate, John and Aquila Reed. Thank you to these friends of Southwestern Adventist University and to music. We have 18 schools participating in this night at Meyerson. I'm going to read the names of the schools, and at the end, I would like to invite the music directors who are here to please stand as well. Adventist Christian Academy of Texas, Brazil Orchestra, Burton Adventist Academy, Chisholm Trail Academy, Cleburne High School, Dallas Christian Academy, Greater Atlanta Adventist Academy, Jefferson Adventist Academy, Ozark Adventist Academy, North Dallas Adventist Academy, Parkview Adventist Academy, Sandia View Academy, San Marcos Adventist Junior Academy, Siagoville High School, South Texas Christian Academy, The Oaks Adventist Christian School, Valley Grande Adventist Academy, I would invite the music directors, the people who have been training these students who have been performing so well, to stand at this time. Thank you so much.
It is a real privilege to welcome again to the podium of the Meyerson Symphony Center student conductor, Jonathan Blue. Please welcome him. Before our next number, I just really am thankful to a group of people here tonight who made this all possible. Will the educators of this union, the music educators of this union, please stand and be recognized? There is yet another group of individuals that deserves our recognition and continual appreciation. This last piece that we played together is dedicated to you. Before we say who you is, many of you who know about American military history know that in World War II, the very first months of the war, it looked pretty bleak. And there was one particular battle that was called Naval Battle that was fought in the region of the Midway Islands, and Midway Island, which is part of the Wake Islands. And the it was an extraordinary thing. And it embodies all that our servicemen and women do to extend themselves that we might appreciate liberty. Those who have served or who are serving in our armed forces, please stand and be recognized. And again, it is because of your blood, sweat, and tears that we can play the Midway March with such ease and swagger. We're thankful for that. We hope you enjoy Midway March.
Thank you.
High tech, okay. All right, now we'll try again. There's something called an on switch. I needed to be aware of that. Southwestern Adventist University is celebrating an important anniversary this year. 120 years ago, a school called Keene Industrial Academy opened its doors. On that first day of school, January 7, 1894, it would have been hard to imagine this concert or the thriving university that supports it. It would also have been difficult, I must say, to imagine this building, this beautiful music hall, since in 1894, Dallas was a dusty and unimpressive town of 40,000 people. Keene Industrial Academy became Southwestern Junior College in 1916 and graduated to being a full four-year college about 50 years later. The university has been known as Southwestern Union College, Southwestern Adventist College, and since 1996, as Southwestern Adventist University. As we celebrate our 120th anniversary, we notice a number of things, a number of changes. Our buildings are bigger and better equipped than the simple wooden structures of 1894. The rules for our students are nowhere near as strict as they were in the beginning. Unlike the first administrators, we don't tell the male students to come to campus with their axes so they can help clear away the timber and brush on school property. And we pay our students a little more than the best rate of 1894, which was $8 a month. But some things are still the same. As we educate tomorrow's nurses, teachers, entrepreneurs, pastors, and scientists, we still believe in the goal we set up at the beginning. As we employ high-tech tools, we can still endorse the old-fashioned goal of 1894. The way they put it was this way: to furnish the youth with an education which shall fit them for the practical duties of life, and do so under influences favorable to promotion of reverence for the Word of God and to the development of Christian character. Or, as an early advertisement put it, good accommodations, experienced teachers, thorough and conservative methods, excellent moral influences, and lowest terms. Music has always been an important part of our education. A 1926 report, for example, listed four major groups: a mixed chorus, an a cappella choir, a men's glee club, and the school orchestra. Tonight's concert supports music education and much more. More than 500 students are performing tonight. Now, few of them, I expect, will become professional musicians. Most of them probably will not even be music majors in college. But all of them are learning something important about discipline and preparation. They will leave this festival with a better understanding of the cultural riches of our civilization. Participants in a night at the Meyerson will also know firsthand that talent leaps boundaries of class, race, and ethnicity. Most important of all, I believe, they will see that education is not about self-promotion, but about honoring God. So thank you tonight for being here, and thank you for supporting life-changing education.
At this time, I would like to take a few minutes to recognize six very special individuals. They spent a lot of time and energy over the past months preparing, practicing, and auditioning for a music festival scholarship. We have donors, as was mentioned at the beginning of the program, that we are eternally grateful for, that help us with the cost of renting this beautiful venue. And you, as you purchase your tickets, are responsible for the scholarship money that is raised this evening. So on behalf of the music department, thank you very much. I would like to introduce right now five of the six scholarship winners. And if you would please come out. We have Carolisa McQueen, we have Dana Wilson, Italo Opazo, Jennifer Ramirez, and Trent Muse. Please give them a round of applause. We thank you very much for all of the hard work that you invested in this, and we are very proud to offer you scholarships. And we'll be talking about that a little bit later, and you'll get official letters from us, and we hope to see you at Southwestern as well. One more of the scholarship winners you will hear in a moment, and he is representing all of them this evening, and his name is Mitchell Wan. And he will be playing a wonderful piece on the Fisk organ as soon as we finish setting up the stage. So thank you very much, and let's give the finalists and the winners a round of applause again. Thank you, go ahead.
The first time I found out about Southwestern was my freshman year, and it was through Music Fest. It's like the university hosting a big music fest, pulling in a whole bunch of people, a bunch of kids from across the union, and that's the first time that I heard about it and was able to get onto the campus. And like that experience, like I fell in love with Southwestern. It felt like a great family place, a place where I could be accepted, you know, everything was just kind of chill, and that's, I liked it. Having a small campus, I'm able to interact with a lot of different people. And definitely inside of that small, I'm able to get out of my comfort zone. So I'm able to talk to, you know, maybe people that I wouldn't generally talk to on a daily basis. Right here at Southwestern, you can definitely get involved from your the first day of your freshman year. I was pulled into praise teams, like, left and right, immediately. People wanted me to come and play.
Like that, right?
So this is breathing in?
Yeah,
so that's what it about for us. And then this is like, when you're interacting with the teachers and stuff, you can get a lot of one-on-one interaction. You're not just coming into a classroom that has 300 people in it, you sit down for a lecture and then leave. The professor never knows your name. Because you go to big name universities, you're just going to be another number on a sheet of paper that comes to class. But here, people know you by name. They care. You can be walking down the sidewalk and be like, oh, hey, Dr. So-and-so, or hey, Miss, you know, whatever. And they'll answer you with your first name, too. Professors actually care about what I'm thinking and about what the issues are that I'm having. When it gets towards Friday afternoon and starts to transition towards Sabbath, there kind of becomes an air that everybody is kind of excited, and Sabbath stuff's coming up. We have Friday Night Vespers, Afterglow, which are really good quality programs. Lots of great music, pulling in great speakers and different events like that.
I will be free of you, Satan, or I will die in the attempt.
essay events and different vespers and worship services. You know, everybody comes together and Southwestern becomes one. Got to experience it to love it. No matter where you come from, no matter who you are, no matter what you're going to choose to do, I guarantee you won't be disappointed. Southwestern is the place to be.
Please put your hands together for Mitchell Wan.
Thank you. Thank you.
The first movement of the Vivaldi Gloria, and we're going to go right into the Dies Irae from the Mozart Requiem, right at the conclusion of the Vivaldi.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Would you stand with me? Let us pray together as we depart this place. Thank you, each and every one, for coming and supporting these students tonight. It means a great deal. We look forward to it every year, and we couldn't do it without you, so thank you very much. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for the gift of music. Thank you for each student that participated tonight. Thank you for their parents. Thank you for their teachers. And as we leave this place tonight, may we carry the songs in our heart, "Give Me Jesus." As we go and we leave this place, may we leave it with you. And if it's thy will, may we all be back here again next year, praising your name. Amen. Thank you very much. Have a great evening.